She's a really fun person, and she have teach me a lot about her life. So I think it's fun.
People fixing the world.
Loneliness is a big issue in Sweden that affects both the young and the old. More than half of all homes have just one occupant, and it's common to live alone after leaving school.
I was kind of lonely when I was living alone. Like, I worked my 8 hours, went home, eat, and went to game. I just like got more depressed.
I had a very comfortable life, but it was so lonely. There were days when I didn't speak to anybody, and you get a bit odd.
This block of flats in Helsingborg is trying to solve the problem. Only people under 25 or pensioners can rent here. And there's an unusual clause in their contract. They have to spend 2 hours a week together. It's run by a housing company funded by the city council.
The young people can bring to the elderly the energy, the know-how, in order to manage the information floats that you have around in the society. We hope that elderly people will bring to the youngsters a little bit of history of how things were before.
The building is a former retirement home that's been given a revamp. There are loads of shared spaces designed to get people socialising. You can cook, do arts and crafts, exercise, or play games together.
We have seen that younger as well as elderly people are trying to make contact to each other and succeed. We didn't have to do anything. It was exactly what we wanted.
Two of the tenants who've made friends are Gunnel and Fia.
Fia has helped me very much with my computer and with TV. I feel much better.
She's a really fun person, and she have teach me a lot about her life. So I think it's fun. Yeah, I do it for fun.
Staff will have a word with those who don't socialise. But so far, everyone seems to be making an effort.
It have been a few small conflicts. It were in the washing room. Someone took another one's time. And a little small conflicts, but it doesn't do much.
More than 70 tenants have moved in since November. Managers hope to open more homes like this in future.
We hope that it will also be a saving for the society, because as they are happier, they will be less sick, they will go less to the doctor. We really hope that it will succeed, not only here in Helsingborg, but all over Sweden and maybe in other parts of the world.